So guys, how are you doing? Okay, now I move to that exercise 2.3, the first question. This is one of the very, very easiest question and a little concept oriented question. Only one point to remember, I will tell you at the end of the question. So, which of the question, like, which of the following will not represent zero? Okay, they are asking which of the following answer is not zero. Okay, that is what they are asking, not represent a zero. See here, option A, 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 is nothing but 1. Option B, 0 into 0. See, one thing is 0 into anything. 0 into anything. It may be number, it may be integer, positive number, negative number. 0 into anything will be 0. This thing you should remember. Okay. Next. Here, 0 divided by 2. Here, 0 divided by 2 is also is equals to 0. Okay. Which means 0 divided by anything. This is also equals to 0. This also you should remember. This also you should remember. And here, option D, 10 minus 10 divided by 2. What is 10 minus 10? 10 minus 10 is 0 divided by 2. See, this also in the form of 0 by anything. This also equals to 0. This is also 0. So it is 0. It is 0. It is 0. And only one thing which is not 0 is option A. Therefore, the correct answer is option A, which will not represent 0. Understand, right? Only one thing you should remember is when we are multiplying with 0 or dividing anything with 0, that always results in 0. This is the point to remember. Okay, we will move on to the next question. Likewise, we understand the concept and we solve the problem. Okay, then only you acquire knowledge while solving the problem. If you solve with pen and paper, then only some patterns will follow in the brain. Some patterns will form in the brain. That is how we gain the knowledge. Okay, so you should write everything which I have written with the pen and the paper. So, and try to understand each and everything what you are writing. If you are not able to understand, just revise this video. Maybe you are sitting in any place like study room or balcony or your sofa set, your comfortable location, maybe in the classroom also, watching with your headphones. Only one thing you should remember is always have a book and write everything which I am teaching in the book. Okay, systematic way. Then only you will learn very easily. This is the simple thing, right? This is not so much hardest thing. Now you are getting a book with cost of some 10 rupees or 20 rupees, a pen with 3 rupees or 5 rupees. You are investing in yourself for learning mathematics. Okay, definitely learning mathematics, maybe you are doing a job in the future or you do business in the future or you go for higher studies in the future. I am sure that whatever I am teaching now will definitely going to be useful for you. Okay, mark my words, you will remember me maybe after 10 years or 20 years later. Okay, that sir has teach me the mathematics. Likewise, okay, invest in yourself is the best investment or the best return that anyone can get. This is not told by me, this is told by the greatest minds that ever exist. Okay, thank you.